Hi Gemini, hey, we are going to look at what is going on for you at the moment, Gemini, and see if there's anything that we can do to actually help you along this path at the moment in this part of your journey of your life. Okay, Gemini, welcome to Juanita's World. I'm Juanita, and here that's exactly what we do. We look at ways to help you on your journey throughout your life, so that we can help people heal. So let's get into it, shall we? First, let me tell you, we're going to use the cosmic reading cards, which I've already pre-shuffled and pulled just to save some time, because it can take me a while to shuffle. And also using the Osho Zen Tarot to just get a bit more information for you, okay, to add on what is coming through. So Gemini, let's start with the first card here, which is a balance. Okay, Gemini, this here is, I mean, obviously it's talking about balance, right? But balance of what? It's balance of your inner worlds. Gemini, how perfect for you. How many inner worlds are inside of you? At least two, Gemini, at least two. Let's face it. But also, Gemini, it's also getting this balance of the inner world and the outer world, right? Because at the end of the day, whatever is going on for you internally is going to be reflected on the external, right? So it's really important to kind of like... To make sure that you're taking care of the things that need to be taken care of for yourself, because at the end of the day, so for example, sorry, I'm trying to just get my words here. For example, if there's something happening on the outside of you that's causing you to, say, feel really drained and tired and exhausted, this could be, Gemini, because you're giving too much of yourself to help others, okay? It might be that you are, and honestly, Gemini, like, the universe is so grateful to you for what you do and the service that you provide to others, but it's really important for you to make sure this is, you're getting back as much as you are giving out, to make sure that is balanced for yourself, to bring that through for yourself, just as much as you really give to other people, okay? What else was I going to say about that? I was going to say something else. I'm just getting yin and yang, making sure that yin and yang is balanced within you, the feminine and the masculine, okay, to make sure that you are just taking care of you, really, Gemini. Wow. Oh, interesting. Understanding. Look at that. This is really interesting. Okay. This here, Gemini, is about you boosting everyone up. You giving everyone, it's like you're the wind beneath people's wings, right? You're boosting them up, allowing them to get out of the cage and fly, and you're still stuck in the cage because you're so exhausted from giving to everyone. You don't have the energy to fly, which is really interesting because I've never got that from that card before. Okay, past lives. I feel like this is about balance again. Okay, but this could be something that is in you, which is carried through from a past life. There's some kind of past life connection here. It's the balance maybe between the past life and this life. Maybe there's some kind of healing that needs to be done from a past life for you. That's interesting. I feel like more might come out about that. I don't feel like I'm quite hitting the nail on the head with that. Let's see if there's anything about, well, okay. I love how they fly out like that. Healing. Yeah, see, healing. Healing. from a past life. Something in your past life needs healing. Now, it could be, Gemini, that there is something that bugs you and you've worked and worked and worked and tried to heal a particular thing and it's just not working, and it could be because it's from a past life. If you're able to, Gemini, see if you can visit, whoops-a-daisy, sorry, I just knocked the table, shake you all about, give you the shake-up, Gemini. if you can, see if you can find a past life regressionist to maybe do some work with you to help heal you, but you can connect in with your guides, with your own higher self, your own consciousness, to actually do that healing. Okay, you just have to ask. Now, okay, so the next one, Gemini, we have here is choices. Okay, so what's this one telling me? Choices. I feel as though, Gemini, there's kind of this conflict between your heart and mind. It's like, it's as though, it's like this taking care of people, right? It's like you really want to do something for yourself, but there are people kind of telling you maybe that you should be doing things for other people, or you know, it could be that people are like, what are you doing that for? That's selfish. What you should be doing is this. You know, and there's something I feel like in you that you would really like to pursue, but it's as though you are being, it could be that there's the sense of being left behind, like you have to stay home and take care of the kids, or you have to stay home and look after the house while everyone else goes out and does their thing, type of thing. And it's as though there's this real need in your soul to start growing, and I think you can feel that. I think you can feel that calling, and it's getting louder, and something tells me that maybe there's something in you that you're not quite satisfied with. For some of you, it could be that you need to push yourself out of that comfort zone. It could be that you're very well just quite happy to do that, because it means that you are not having to deal with any of those fears, right? But you know what? Everything that you have done right now in your life is done. It's time to reap the rewards of everything that you have given and give back to yourself. It's time for you to have some of those fruits, okay? Because you know, you definitely are worthy of having more in your life, and being able to step out of this, I feel like this rut that you're in a sense, Gemini. Yeah, you know, and it could be that there, for you, Gemini, there are so many choices that you just don't know what to pick. Okay, but there is this, it has just jumped out, as you might have seen. This is the dream. It's like, this is you here, sitting here, wishing you could have this. You know, wishing that that was you. And feeling a little bit like you've been left behind, in a sense. And it's time for you to go out and explore. It's time for you to explore the world, Gemini. Now, this leads me to this card here. Okay, believe. First of all, I want to say, believe that you are worthy of what your dreams. You are totally 100% more than worthy of them, Gemini. Okay, it's like this one here. You're seeing others shine and having their time, right? And it's as though it's like, oh, I wish I could have that. And not really thinking that you have the ability or that that would ever happen for you. But it can. It 100% can. But it's like something has to change for you, right? You have to change it. You can't just sit there and wait for it to happen. you've got to change things for yourself. The other thing is Gemini, there's part of this that is a bit of fear in there. Because I can feel a little bit like, it's more what I'm seeing. It's like there's the shadow, the silhouette of this person behind the colours, right? And it's like this person wants to break out and wants to be free, but I don't know, is it fear of being seen maybe, or not feeling like you quite fit, or maybe you haven't found your niche yet? It could be that you don't quite believe that you're worthy, maybe. But also it could be fear of, what if people laugh at me? What if I look stupid? What if it doesn't work out? Who cares? You're not going to know unless you try, right? And you're also not going to know if what you're doing is what you like. You know, you might have an idea of what it is that you want to do. It could be that you thought you wanted to stay in the cage and wanted to be home and do all this stuff, but then you see everyone else doing flying and you're like, oh, wish I could do that. And the fact of the matter is you can, but you just haven't stepped out of your comfort zone yet, okay? And part of this fear could need healing from, it could be from a past life. And you may not know what the fear is, but it's just there. I feel like there's this need to step, you know, to understand that nothing's perfect. Interesting. This reminds me of balance. It's schizophrenia. And I feel like there's this, a real indecisiveness. Part of that could be also you pretending to be like, oh yes, I'm doing this thing here and this is really wonderful, but deep down inside you have these desires, but you're just too afraid to start them because you're so used to being in this cage. And what on earth would people think if you dared try to step out and fly like these birds and step out and fly like these birds? Oh my goodness. The other thing is that stepping out of that comfort zone feels very vulnerable to you, okay? Everything feels pretty ordinary, but I want you to know that within the ordinary is beauty. Okay, you can find that beauty in your life and you can express that because that's actually inside of you, I feel, Gemini, and it's there ready to come out. It's kind of bursting to come out. You're just wandering along like, oh yeah. It's the same old path that you've walked, and I think you're getting a little bit bored here, okay? The other thing here, this is really interesting, but this also, sorry, I have to come back to this. This also feels like it's along the lines of this ripeness. It's as though, things are ready to be harvested. Oh, okay, I get it, okay. So you planted the garden. The garden has grown and it's blossomed. This could be about your family, okay? Your family could be growing, your kids could be growing, and they're all ready to, they've branched out on your own. You've helped nurture them to do that, and they're flowing the coop kind of thing. They've left the nest, and off they go, okay? And you've done your work, and now it's like, oh, now what am I going to do? You know, it could be, Gemini, that you've been working at the same workplace for a really long time and you've mastered everything. And now you're like, boring, but I don't know what else to do. And I don't want to, you know, that element of comfort keeps you there and it keeps you stuck, okay? This mirrored souls here, this is about people around us who reflect things that are hidden in us for us to see. So it could very well be that you've got people around you right now who are showing you aspects of yourself that are really irritating you. and it's really maybe annoying you. Okay. And they'll show you, you know, parts of yourself that are nice and those parts that are challenging, okay? And it's really important to look at both of these things, all right, rather than just the nice. It's important to look at the shadow self in a sense as well, and people around you will reflect that. Whatever it is that you need to work on, people around you will reflect those things that need to be worked on, type of thing. Okay. Yeah, I feel like Gemini, there's part of this, like, I'm really drawn to this heart center here, and I feel like all this nurturing that you've done, and with the messages that are coming through, this is also about you now giving back to yourself to, like I said earlier, give back to yourself, you know, nurture yourself, make sure you're taking the time to balance that out, okay? It's about self-love and self-worth, okay? And making sure that you're building yourself up just like you did everyone else. So this first card that came out here, politics, okay? Politics. This is just getting really devious kind of energy here, which I always don't get with this card, even though it looks it, but that's really jumping out to me right now. This could be your shadow self that you don't want to see, and I'm not calling you devious, I'm not saying that you're devious, but it is this representing the shadow self of this really lovely mask that we wear, and oh, so it's lovely and blah blah blah, and then the other part of ourselves that is like, oh, no one's seeing this side of me, right? And actually really are looking at that and addressing it and not being afraid of it, because it's part of us. And all this thing about loving ourselves is loving that side of ourselves too. And while you hide that in the dark, it starts to rear its ugly head more and more, because it wants to be seen and it wants to be acknowledged, right? So it's important. You don't have to go out to the world and show them that. But just within yourself, just acknowledge that that exists, and look at it. Bring it out to look at. Be honest with yourself. That's all part of loving yourself. And it could be that you don't feel worthy because you have this aspect, these aspects in yourself. And so you're like, well, if I was really worthy of this loving relationship, then I wouldn't have that ugly aspect in myself. So I'm not worthy, and I'm not even going to bother, because who's going to want to love me when I've got that? Well, guess what? Everyone has that. No one is exempt, no matter how lovely they seem. Everyone has a dark side. Everybody. Okay, make no mistake. Moment to moment. Living moment to moment. Step by step. Do this step by step, okay? Be patient with yourself. Be gentle with yourself. Do not be hard on yourself, Gemini, okay? Do not beat yourself up. Do not let that horrible twin... Do I want these? No. Don't let that horrible twin be nasty to you about it, okay? Turning in... Oh, sorry. Let's start with this. I'm getting ahead of myself here, getting all like, come on, we gotta say new chapter. This is a new chapter for you, Gemini, okay? Because you know, there has been this change inside of you, like this niggling kind of like wanting to move forward in your life, and it's happening within. It's just a matter of bringing it on into the outside world, okay? Bringing it out for people to see. Because you see here, this bright light, I feel like, is your internal, okay? And it's these fears again. It's these fears of you not wanting to bring it out, but tuning in and allowing yourself just to take some time, silence those emotions, silencing all this chatter. See all these voices here, these people here, chatter, 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 chatter. This person's serene. Calming the emotions, okay, calming those voices, because I know, like, you know, that might be the Gemini twin, but it's like there's freaking, you know, 20 of you in there sometimes. So, you know, yeah, just taking that time to tune in and eliminating, well, not even eliminating the fears, maybe just more kind of like acknowledging they're there and just going, okay, we're going to do this anyway, type thing, like that whole thing of facing the fear and doing it anyway, you know. Anything else for new chapter for Gemini? new chip. Change. Change. Look at that. Just really what new chapter is about. Change. Again, centering yourself, okay? There's all this whirlwind going on outside of you, which I feel like more is internal, more in the head, but you can come into your heart and just center yourself, okay? Because this is the place that you want to lead from rather than this, because this here is going to lead you astray if you allow it to take over, okay? I mean, there is intuition, which you'll feel in the gut and you'll hear that in your mind, but you'll know in your gut. But once the ego takes over, whew, off it goes. Okay, so the next card here we have is communication. And this I feel is about your inner voice, Gemini. Okay, it's like you need to be heard, and it's kind of like what's happening is you want to speak out because you've always been that person to be this person who sits back. Right now, you're like, hang on a minute, it's my turn, hello, can anyone see me, can anyone hear me? And people are just doing their thing, which is kind of what they've been taught to do, because that's been everyone's roles. Okay, so then it's like, go, oh, for goodness sakes, like, why aren't you listening to me? And then you get met with defensiveness, because that's what's within you. Okay, so then where's that card? This mirroring comes out, right? So people are mirroring one another. So if you, you know, come within and get this serenity within you, okay, then you will kind of break that mold. You will be able to have what is mirrored back to you, what is within you. Okay, so bring the into the heart space and get the serenity within, so that what you're getting back is that. Okay, because this here is kind of like, to me, representative of mind games. And it just really goes on and on in your head and doesn't achieve anything, okay? And it just comes back at you, really. So, making sure that that communication is clear and concise, but also from the heart and very loving, so that that's what you get back. And your communication is not only verbally, it's also through your vibration. Friendliness. Oh, look at that. Friendliness, so that everyone can come together rather than separating, because as you can see here, the colors are blending, so it's finding a way to work together and coming in and sharing what it is that, you know, everyone has to, you know, what is it that everyone has to bring to the table, type of thing, and really getting on board with one another and working together rather than working against one another. Okay, anything else about communication? The Gemini. Is that, no. One more time. Communication for Gemini. There we go. Okay, existence coming into this sense of realizing that you are connected to everything. Okay, this communication is not just about, you know, like I said, it's not verbally only, it's about your vibration, and your vibration is what is out in the universe, okay, and it gets sent out to the universe, and that's how it all comes back to us, and that's how this mirroring effect happens, okay, so, you know, this is kind of part of that coming into this peacefulness here, so that we can tune into the universe, and that's going to help us receive the messages and the guidance that we really need. Walk your truth. This is exactly what this is talking about to me. This hand here, it's like your fingerprint, like really putting your mark on the world, making yourself known, and it's your own. Yeah. I kind of feel like this, you know, it's like, I mean, I know it says walking your truth, but it just, I can't accentuate that enough. It's kind of really standing in your power and going, this is me, this is all of me and who I am, and own it. own it with a passion, man. Like, really, really let your light shine and be proud of that. And I feel like coming into this existence and getting into this space here and tuning in is going to help you come to this, okay? And I feel like this is what your soul has been yearning for. And I feel as though you know that, but you're just not quite sure how to do that. So definitely start with meditating if you haven't already. But also for some of you, you know what you're meant to be doing, but you're just too afraid to take the next step. And all you have to do, Gemini, is take one step. One step. Oh, yeah, look at this. Oh, my gosh. Look at this. Look at this power behind these cards here. Look at this. Master, transformation, walk your truth. Walk your truth. Right? Look at that. That is incredible. I mean, I don't even know if I have to say anything about these cards because it seems to me just so clear, right? There's this master within you, Gemini. You are the master of your own world. You know, you have this inside of you to bring out. You don't really need to do anything other than to be, okay? But the problem is that you doubt yourself, and this is really what this is, a matter of clearing those doubts so that you can have this transformation and rise up and be that, shine your light, really, right? Limitless, Gemini. Become, can you even see that? Sorry. Become limitless, right? Letting go of all those internal limits, breaking out of the external limits, right? Limits from society, limits from family, limits from expectations, your own limits, right? Seeing what your limiting beliefs are and setting yourself free, standing up and going, no more, breaking free, stepping out of the cage, no more, I'm flying, and I'm going to show you fellas how it's done. Bam, right there. Gemini? Do it now. Anything else about limitless? See, also here, sorry, I just have to go to this one, sacred journey. Now, Gemini, with this here, this is about the shadow self again, okay? Do not be afraid of it, all right? Because it is part of us, okay? You can't have yin and yang without the dark. Okay, because it wouldn't be a symbol, right? It doesn't work. It would just be like a round white circle. You have to have the dark. It is balance. Like the first card at the beginning, it is about balance, okay? You have to have the dark, and there's nothing wrong with it, okay? So don't be afraid of it. It's like, it's a bit like at nighttime when you're, say, walking along and it's really pitch black and you can't see anything, you hear a noise, it's like, what's that? I don't know what that is. Is that a boogeyman or is that, like, what is that? You know, and you're just not too sure. And that's what the shadow self is about. It's really fear of the unknown and just not being sure of what is quite going to come out, you know. But the thing is, Gemini, it's not like once you bring it out, it's not as bad as what you feel like it would be. Okay. Oh, excuse me. Also, Gemini, I want to say about this that, you know, if there's been dark times in your life, that look back at those dark times, you know, without fear, and just see the lessons in them, learn from them, you know, and try and separate yourself from the suffering of these times so that you can really step into this higher consciousness and start vibrating at a higher level, okay? And this is going to help you move forth, okay? So let's just see if there's any last advice or words or anything for Gemini regarding these last two cards. Anything else here? I don't even know. Intensity. Do it with intensity. I know I feel quite intense about this as well. Comparison. Stop comparing yourself to others, okay? These two here are both trees, all right, Gemini? They are both trees, but they are completely different. Not one is better than the other. So stop comparing yourself to others and what they have achieved or what they've done in their life, right? Okay, and realize that you have the ability to flower and shine your light just like everybody else does. Okay, Gemini. I think that's it, Gemini. I really do. I can't believe it's like nearly half an hour already and it just feels like it's gone like that. Okay, Gemini, well, thank you for sharing this time with me. And please subscribe and like this video, comment, share. The whole idea is to help you, help other people. So the more we can get it out there, the more we can help people along with their journey in their life, okay? So thank you so much, Gemini, for sharing your energy with me. I really appreciate it. Take care of your beautiful self. Okay, bye-bye.